The world is in a modern-day gold rush. This time, however, the treasure is not buried underground. It's right above us. Just like those pioneers who chased their dreams in the past, today's pioneers venture into space. Whether you use your smartphone to make a phone call, to check the weather, or to browse the internet, you are literally tapping into the benefits of space technology. And I believe that Australia, much like in the past, is the perfect starting point for one of the biggest gold rushes in history. With NASA Artemis lighting up the celestial stage, returning to the moon is not just a giant leap for humanity. No, it's a booster for dreams and the future launch pad for the future of space. But there's a catch. Space is hard. And getting things into space is even harder. Sure, we have the rocket technologies developed, but you also need a place from where you can launch your rocket. What you need is a spaceport. A spaceport is like an airport, just with rockets launching and returning instead of airplanes. It's not just a concrete slab. It's a hub where astronauts and equipment and cargo is prepared to go on a space mission. A spaceport to the space economy is like the shovel to the miner. You need one before you can even start. But there's a problem. Currently, there's a long waiting line in order to use one. 2 years, in fact. This is a huge bottleneck, stopping research, technological development, and a wide range of commercial applications. So what's the solution? I did my PhD in aerospace engineering. I was always fascinated by anything spacey, and I was involved in a number of space or space-related projects over the last couple of years. I have my own YouTube channel talking about space science and technology. In hindsight, all these projects have the same theme: to build a sustainable space economy in Australia. And let's be honest, who else wants a sustainable space economy down under? The problem with rocket scientists like me: we have been trained to think like a hammer. So therefore, all problems look like a nail. So naturally, I also thought developing more and better rockets is the answer. I've spent the last 4 years on this problem, and I realized we have enough rockets. We need more spaceports. But not just any spaceport. We need spaceports capable of heavy launch. Heavy launch means sending 20 tons or more at once into space. It's basically like sending busloads full of stuff instead of a bunch of smaller launches. This is overall more energy efficient and therefore also cheaper. Currently, we only have a handful of spaceports globally that are capable of heavy launch. And most of them are not open to the public and access is heavily restricted. Those who are accessible are super busy. SpaceX is using two of them every month to build a network worldwide for fast and reliable internet, Starlink. To do so, they have to send 44,000 satellites into space. With the current launch capabilities we have, it will take decades in order to send 44,000 satellites up there. And this is just one project amongst many others. There are researchers, commercial companies, and entire nations who want to send stuff into space. This is already a huge demand, and it's predicted that this demand will triple within the next decade, even without NASA Artemis on the horizon. With all these people, it's like 1,000 miners sharing one shovel. By making access to space more accessible, cheaper, quicker, and sustainable, we open up new opportunities and entire new markets for all of us. Imagine sending something into space is as easy as creating a new website or starting a new business. So, where should we build our spaceport? Launching closer from the equator gives us a head start for our space race. Because at the equator, Earth's rotational speed is the fastest. To put this in perspective, launching from the equator allows an extra 1,000 kilograms per launch. At a price tag of about 4,000 Australian dollars per kilogram, that would mean we save or make $4 million more per launch. But just starting from the right point is not enough to win the space race. Who has ever heard that a launch has been delayed because of bad weather? In fact, bad weather is the most common reason for launch cancellation. A perfect location is one where we have predictable weather patterns so that we can plan many launches ahead of time. And as I mentioned before, launching rockets is hard. So in the event of the unexpected, you don't want anybody near the launch trajectory. So therefore, our spaceport should operate far away from people. We also need space to build launch pads and hangars, fuel storages, and assembly facilities needs a lot of space and room. It is like building an entire space city from scratch. For example, Starbase, the home base for Starship from SpaceX in Boca Chica, is 400,000 square meters large. The Kennedy Space Center is even larger, 25 million square meters. That's half the size of Manhattan Island. We also need access to a strong workforce. From builders to lawyers and managers and engineers, we need everyone. And as every city, we need a well-connected network. Railways, docks, airports, and so on. It's a bustling metropolis to support our heavy launch rocket as it embarks on a space mission. We also need to deal and navigate the politics. If you involve multiple countries in one launch, it can be tricky. If you launch a rocket in one country and fly over another, it can be really hard to deal with that as well. So an ideal launch location is one where you launch and fly until you reach space under one single jurisdiction. Speaking of flights, we also want clear access to the sky with no aviation routes going through our launch facility or the area around it. We also want an area where we have no political surprises so that our rockets and the people who work on our spaceport are safe and so that businesses can plan ahead of time. It's now easy to see that Western Australia is meeting many of these requirements, if not even all, easily. Let's take a peek into the future, where Western Australia emerges as a beacon of opportunity to respond to the demand of the world to launch. In this future, developing a heavy launch spaceport has transformed the landscape and built and started a thriving space economy. It's a bustling hub of space economic activities. Imagine driving along the coast of Western Australia with space facilities everywhere. It sounds like science fiction, but it could be real. And it could happen right here in Western Australia. So where do we go from here? In the future, where a heavy launch spaceport has enabled us to unlock the space economy. Space is not just there for rocket scientists and astronauts. It's a part of our everyday identity in Western Australia. I invite you to think about how you can be involved in shaping this future. Imagine sending your kids to a cool space job without the necessity to move overseas. Imagine sending our workers to the moon instead of a mine site. Of course, we wouldn't call it fly in, fly out anymore. It would be rocket in, rocket out. Together, we can unlock this future. Whether you are an entrepreneur with a groundbreaking concept, an innovator with a dream, or a citizen with a hunger for space, there's a part for everyone on this incredible journey. In a future where the moon is accessible, Mars is a possibility, the stars will no longer be out of reach. A heavy launch spaceport will not only eliminate the sky as the limit, a heavy launch spaceport is also a spaceport and a launch pad to an era of full possibilities for everyone. Thank you. We'll be right back.